that clearly contradict traditions should override the modern images and the worldly messages of the identity of who the true Jews are and the other tribes, who the Hebrews are. So regardless of your tradition and regardless of what images the scripture has to stand first and foremost. So let's quickly go, because we're looking at the history of the children of Israel. So you want to know somebody? Let's see where they're born. Where they're born. Let's just go through the scriptures. Ezekiel 16:3 says, "Thus saith the Lord Yahweh to Jerusalem," and we forget Canaan's Cush, "and your father was an Amorite, your mother a Hittite." It's not spiritual words, it's not figuratively speaking. We know that from Canaan, one of the four sons of Ham, you have the Amorites and the Hittites. Very important. Psalm 105:23 says, "Israel also came into Egypt, and Jacob sojourned in the land of Ham," which is Canaan. Amos 9:7, "Are ye the children of the Ethiopians? Oh, are ye not as the children of the Ethiopians unto me, O children of Israel, says the Lord." This map is also a wonderful find. This is an old map of the continent of Africa. The name is Ethiopia. It wasn't always named Africa, you know. And what's the name of that ocean? Oh, the Ethiopic Ocean. It wasn't always the Atlantic Ocean. So this is our history, y'all, our history. So when I read Amos 5:9-7, I like to say, "Are ye not as the Africans to me, O children of Israel?" Song of Solomon 5-6, Solomon describing himself, "I am black, but comely. O ye daughters of Jerusalem, as the tents of Kedar, as the curtains of Solomon, look upon me because I am black, because the sun hath looked upon me." And here I found a definition of the word Kedar from 1813 edition of the Smith's Bible Dictionary. And it says Kedar, black skin, black-skinned man. And it encourages me to read the Bible in a different way. So let's look at the Hebrews from the historians, what the historians say. 1955 AD, Tacitus, he says, the Judeans are a race of Ethiopic origin. And there's my favorite old map again. I keep saying these old maps, every one of them is my favorite. But there's the Ethiopic Ocean. I love it. Okay. So let's look at some artifacts. Yeah, that's a real artifact right there. You can see the Negro, and that's very important. That's a very important term. I forgot the resource, and I promise myself that I will find it to show that the word Negro is actually tied into Hebrew, your identity. So when I use the word Negro now, I use it as the identification of a Hebrew people. And that's one of the reasons why the word Negro is not as popular, that we use terms like black and African American, because your identity is in your name. So here we have a depiction of the Hebrews at work. This is in the tomb of Reckmeyer the vizier, And this is dated around the time of Thutmose III. And you have Hebrews making bricks. This particular picture, by the way, is in the Pictorial History of the Jewish People, the 1984 edition, page 22. So it's fantastic that in the history of the Jewish people, you have Negroes identified as Jews. But it's easy to overlook that because it's small and it is in black and white. You know, but we take things for granted, so we don't pause to look beyond what we assume to be true. Here is some work from, in this particular case, we have ceramic art from Tel El Yehudia. That's Jew town or mounds of the Jews in Arabs, in Arabic. And that's a nice archaeological find right there. By the way, a lot of these sites do not get the attention and they're going to rot because you just can't have the truth and the information out there. You know, so that's a prayer point. Here we have another artifact, another piece of pottery. This is from a book, Views of the Biblical World. It's a Jewish book printed in Jerusalem, 1960s. And here is a scripture I want to read with that. Jeremiah 15:3, it says, I will appoint over them four kinds of destroyers, says the Lord. The sword to slay, the dogs to tear, the birds of the air, and the beasts of the earth to devour and destroy. And when I see the Hebrews with the bird eating the skeleton, eating them, reminds me of that scripture. And I want to bring out the ethnicity of the Hebrews. There's that nice Afro right there. Here, I also love this. This is when Sennacherib of Assyria laid siege to Lachish, 32. He was so proud of the captivity of Judah that in his palace he created an entire relief that told the story of his victory. And it is in the British Museum in London. And you can also see the Hebrews themselves being taken into captivity. And again, you can see the ethnicity of the Jews. This is our scripture. Do you know how excited it is to read the story in 2 Chronicles? And there, it's in the British Museum. I can go on the computer and I can see the depiction of the entire story. That's exciting. Why do we know this stuff? So here are some other historical images. In the catacombs in Rome, what's a catacomb? A catacomb is basically an underground burial place. Miles and miles, like 12 miles of tunnels, over 90 acres, different levels. About 500,000 people are buried, even in the oldest one called San Castillo Callisto. Okay. And there was a law in Rome, 200 to 400 AD, you couldn't bury your dead above ground. So they cremate. But if you're a Christian, you go underground. Okay. And here are some wonderful artwork from the Jews and Christians. And you can see pictures of our Lord and Bible characters that you wouldn't ordinarily see. This is a picture of Jonah being thrown overboard. One of our favorite Bible story. This is an icon. It's painted on canvas. It's located in Minco Vesta. And it's huge. It's a picture of baby Mary. Here's baby Mary
Here is Zechariah. Here's Mary's parents, Saint Anna and Saint Joachim. And here they are again. And one of the rules in iconography is that you can't just have your artistic interpretation of a figure. It had to be true to life. And this was before the cameras. So that's just another rule. The bottom line is that people haven't changed all that much. So we can't look at our history and say to ourselves, oh, that's how a people used to look back in the day. But they changed so much that they actually become a different race of people. You know? But this is our history, and it does matter. So when we read from the Zondervan Bible Dictionary and the Young's Bible Dictionary and the New Standard Encyclopedia, and we look at the word, and it tells us things that we're not taking note of because our mind is trained in another way. You know, I trust that this presentation helped you to understand a little more why the Bible dictionaries would let you know that even though Ham is the progenitor of the dark race, it is incorrect to describe a Negro as Ham, because a Negro is not Ham. A Negro is a people, that's Shem. So even though Ham and Shem and the dark races may occupy a particular land mass, the African continent, there are different people groups, different nations who are occupying that land mass. Okay, good?
Yes.
All right. So the next topic we'll look at after a short break will be the physical image of our world.